Hey there, it's Matt from Style Factory, the go-to website for e-commerce reviews and advice. In today's video, I'm going to discuss Shopify pricing plans. Stay tuned to the end to get our top tips on how to access the best Shopify free trial, pick the best value plan, and get a good discount on your Shopify subscription. Before I dive in though, it'd be great if you could take a moment to like this video, subscribe to our channel, and hit the notifications bell. This helps us out and will give you easy access to all our other Shopify tips in future. Right, so let's get started with a key question. Can you actually use Shopify for free? Unlike some competing e-commerce platforms like Big Cartel or Ecwid, you can't use Shopify entirely for free. However, there are free trials of Shopify available, and these are usually extendable by request. The key thing to note before starting a free Shopify trial is that there are actually two types of trial available. The regular free trial, which you'll find a link to in the video description, can be accessed easily from the Shopify website. This trial lasts 14 days and is best suited to merchants who want to stock and sell their own products. However, if you're interested in using Shopify to dropship products, there's a better trial available, one that guides you through the process of setting up a dropshipping business and gives you a lot of really useful resources to help you do it successfully. This special dropshipping trial is actually a little bit tricky to come across if you're not looking for it, but you'll find a link to it in the video description below. Once you've finished your free trial, you'll need to pick a Shopify plan. Let's go through the available plans now, starting with the starter plan. The Starter Plan. At $5 per month, Shopify's Starter Plan represents one of the cheapest ways into selling products online, but you need to be aware that it doesn't provide you with a fully functional, standalone online store. Instead, it allows you to sell products on an existing website, sell on social media platforms like Facebook or Instagram, and sell on messaging apps like WhatsApp and Messenger. A key feature of the Shopify Starter Plan is a Buy button that lets you embed your products on another website. You simply add a snippet of code to your website and your Shopify products or catalogs appear on it. Once you've added a Buy button to your website, any changes you make to your products in Shopify will be automatically updated on it. However, the Shopify Starter Plan won't be for everyone. First, the transaction fees are very high, 5% of each sale. Second, unlike the other Shopify plans, the Starter Plan doesn't come with any point of sale features, meaning that you can't use it to sell products in physical locations. And finally, the fact that you can't build a standalone website with the Starter Plan will rule it out for a lot of merchants. So, a lot of potential Shopify users tend to skip the Starter Plan and head straight for the basic one. Let's take a look at that. The Basic Plan. At $29 per month, the Basic Plan is the cheapest Shopify plan that enables you to create a fully functional, standalone online store. Importantly, it also lets you sell products at point of sale, meaning that you can use your Shopify account to sell products in physical locations like retail stores, market stalls, and pop-up shops. You also get content marketing tools like a blog, the option to present your store in multiple languages, and full control over your store's SEO. And finally, on the Basic Plan, you'll pay lower credit card fees and transaction fees. In fact, if you use Shopify's built-in payment processor, Shopify Payments, you won't have to pay any transaction fees at all. All in all, the Basic Shopify Plan is a great starting point for most merchants. You'll find a link to more information about it in the video description. Now, let's take a look at the Shopify Plan. The Shopify plan costs $79 per month, a considerable step up from the basic plan in terms of monthly outgoings, but you do get some key additional functionality for this extra investment. For a start, you get more user accounts. 5 people can log into your account if you're on the Shopify plan, as opposed to just 2 if you're on the basic plan. You also get more inventory locations to play with. While the basic plan limits you to managing your products in 4 locations, you can do so with 5 on the Shopify plan. Additionally, you get lower transaction and credit card processing fees. The analytics are better too. While the reports available on the basic plan mainly involve simple dashboards, you get access to a lot more detailed e-commerce data on the Shopify plan. But most significantly, you get access to e-commerce automation tools. The Shopify Plan lets you add the Shopify Flow app, which gives you sophisticated ways to automate tasks and processes within your store and across your apps. In short, the Shopify Plan is a good option for power sellers that want more detailed data on their customers and more ways to automate aspects of their e-commerce business. But if you want to take things up a notch further on the functionality front, you might need to take a look at Shopify's Advanced Plan. Let's go through that now. The Advanced Plan. The Advanced Plan costs $299 per month and is the most fully featured Shopify plan aimed at small businesses and solopreneurs. It gives you 8 inventory locations, 15 user accounts, lower transaction and credit card processing fees, and advanced customizable reporting tools. But the most significant thing that the Advanced Plan brings to the table is much stronger functionality for selling internationally. Unlike all the other Shopify plans I've covered in this video so far, the Advanced Plan lets you set individual product prices for individual countries. This lets you price products accurately for local markets, rather than rely on a currency conversion that might not reflect market realities. You can also set duties and import taxes using the Advanced Plan, something that the other plans I've discussed don't facilitate. So for me, the main reason you might want to use the Advanced Plan over the others is if you want to sell internationally. It really gives you a lot of functionality and flexibility on this front. Now, so far we've gone through the Shopify plans that are aimed at individuals and small businesses. But there's one more Shopify plan to consider, and that's one that's been designed with more corporate entities in mind. Let's take a look at it. The Shopify Plus plan. The pricing for Shopify Plus is negotiable, but you're typically looking at around $2,000 per month. For this, you get all the functionality provided by the Advanced Plan, but Shopify Plus also gives you a host of features typically required by larger e-commerce businesses. These include a dedicated account manager, full control over the checkout process, automatic currency conversion based on IP address, better access to Shopify's API, an unlimited number of user accounts, and enhanced security features. Perhaps most significantly, Shopify Plus lets you create and manage up to 10 stores at once. So if you are running a lot of e-commerce websites and need a lot of advanced features for them, Shopify Plus arguably represents your best value option. But for a full lowdown of how Shopify Plus differs from the other Shopify plans, and to see if it really is worth the investment, I'd suggest taking a look at our Shopify versus Shopify Plus comparison. You'll find a link to this in the video description. What's the best value Shopify plan? So, after all that, what's the best value Shopify plan for you? Well, for merchants starting out, I normally recommend the basic plan. It's a well-rounded option that gives you the core e-commerce tools you need without breaking the bank. For merchants in need of better reporting and more e-commerce automation features, but without a need for advanced international selling tools, the Shopify plan is a good option. If a key business aim is to sell internationally, then the Advanced plan is the best starting point. And if you want to manage multiple Shopify stores at once, or need enterprise-class features and account management services, then Shopify Plus is probably for you. Now, once you've decided upon a Shopify plan, you may be able to avail of quite a substantial discount for it. Let's take a look at how to do that. Getting a discounted Shopify plan. Normally speaking, Shopify gives you 10% off your plan if you pay upfront for 1 year, 20% off if you pay upfront for 2 years, or 25% off if you pay upfront for 3 years. However, sometimes the company runs more significant promotional discounts. It's not unheard of, for example, to be able to avail of a 50% discount off a Shopify plan or to get 3 months off your plan for free. These discounts usually depend upon your location and come and go throughout the year, but it's always worth checking the Shopify pricing page for offers before upgrading from a free trial to a paid plan. That way, you can make sure you're aware of any promotional discounts and can follow the right links to get to them. You'll find a link to the official Shopify pricing page in the video description. And that's it, our guide to Shopify pricing plans and how to pick the right one for your business. There's lots more to learn about Shopify pricing, however, so do make sure you check out our full blog post about this topic. You'll find a link to it in the video description. To get all our latest Shopify tips, do subscribe to our channel and hit the notifications bell. And finally, if you have any queries about Shopify, don't forget to leave a comment. We read them all and we'll do our best to help.